Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create commands inside of your Discord bot. So to start things off, I have this very basic index.js file which simply just runs our bot and says that the bot is ready. If you want to clone this from the GitHub repository, a link can be found in the video description. So to make this super easy for us, I'm actually going to create a command utility inside of another file. So we can go to new file, I'm going to call this command.js, and we're going to say module.exports. We're going to export a function here. The first parameter will be the client, which will be the actual Discord bot. That way we can use this to listen for whenever someone sends a message in a channel and then see if it's actually the command that we want. The next option is going to be the aliases, and this will include the main command. The next option is going to be the callback, which will be the function that will be ran whenever someone actually runs this command. So one thing I want to do is I want to set up a prefix inside of our config.json file. We can do this by simply just saying prefix, and we're going to have an exclamation point. Of course, you can change this to whatever you want. And in future videos, I'll show you how you can actually have each server configure this to make sure that the prefix doesn't actually interrupt with any other bots they have. So if we save this, we can then import that. We're going to destructure prefix from require config.json. And then we want to say client.onMessage. And this is going to have a callback, which will have a message parameter. We can then get the content of the message, which is the actual text. And one thing we want to do is we want to allow this method to be called from an array, such as ping and test, or as a string, such as just ping. So if we have multiple commands that we want to be able to run this, such as additional ones could be called aliases, that basically are like shorthand notations or shorter ways or different ways of running the same command. We want to be able to specify all of those. If we don't have any of those, we want to just pass in a string. And so one thing we can do here is we can say if type of aliases is exactly equal to string, we're then going to say aliases equals an array of aliases. So this would become a string or an array of strings like this right here. And this way we can actually loop through these to see if the user ran one of these things. So we're going to say aliases.forEach, and we're going to have an alias. So inside here, we want to create a command constant, and this will be a string literal. They'll have prefix, which is what we import from our configuration, and directly afterwards with no spaces, we're going to have alias. So let's say that our command is going to be ping, and the console would then, or the bot would then reply to that user with pong. And then also let's say that we want to make sure that we have an alias that says test, but we want to make sure that testing does not actually run. So there's a certain way we have to do this. And I'll explain better once we have the code written out. So we can say if the content.starts with a string literal, which is command space, or content is exactly equal to command. Then we can say console.log, the string literal, running the command. And then we can run the callback, and the callback will pass in a message. That way that the callback would then have access to the channel and the actual content of the message, the author of the message, or whatever else it may need. So I'm going to get rid of these comments here. We can save this. We're going to go into our index.js file, and we're going to go ahead and import this. Command equals require command. And then we're going to say command. We're going to pass in the client. This will be ping. And then we're going to have a callback, which will have a message. And we simply want to say message.channel.send. Pong. So if we save this and we run our app with node index.js, we then see our tutorial bot is online. If we say exclamation point ping, it then says pong. So that seems to work. If we do exclamation point hello, nothing actually happens. So now to test out the aliases, if we change this string to an array and we say ping and then test, we can then save this. We can rerun the bot. And we can then do exclamation point ping. That works as expected. Exclamation point test. That also works. However, exclamation point testing does not work. The reason for that is because we are seeing if the content starts with the command with a space afterwards, or if the content is exactly equal to the command. So the reason why we're doing the space here is because you might want to be able to tag someone or add in some text afterwards that the command might have to gain access to. And so if we just checked if the content is exactly equal to the command, then the users who are actually running the command cannot add in additional information. Obviously, in this exact case, that doesn't actually matter. However, in the future videos, I'll be showing you cases where it would matter what content they add in after the command. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the WarnoffKeys Discord, which can be found in the video description.